Okay, you want me to give the recap?
Yeah, sure.
Me with my my good old voice right now. So we last left off. We went to the mountain. We fought a bunch of evil stuff. We found the earrings. Yuma died. Yuma came back to life. She found her father. Then we continued on a little bit, tried to find a way out, which we kind of did. We had to get a big old sapphire to fuel a spell. Yuma died. She came back.
No, she didn't die.
She almost died.
Yeah.
I mean, to her credit, she didn't roll death throws. She just kind of like...
And she didn't just die. She was killed.
Yeah, okay. Fair enough. So yeah, then we teleported back to, whatever it's called.
Amita,
yes. I would know.
You should know.
And, Toby and I leveled up to level 6. Wrath, you want us to go... We technically don't have it yet, but you want us to go over what we got?
Yeah. Go ahead.
I just feel lucky. That's about it.
What's that?
I just feel lucky, so that's it. I got lucky. We got the feet lucky. It's the we customized it. I can now, instead of just the normal luck rolls, I can now add a flat 5 to whatever roll I want. And there's a lot of noise because Mboy's at work right now. That's dedication.
Stupidity. I'll just mute myself when I'm not talking.
Okay. And then, yeah, so that's it for me. How about you, Toby?
You mean for level 6?
Yep.
My big thing now is that as a level 6, when I turn into an animal, my attacks are magical, or equivalent to magical, or I can hit things that need a magical weapon to hit.
Mm-hmm.
And part of that is now I can be a cave bear, so that's pretty cool.
You cannot be CR level 2, right?
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
As far as magic, I've got an extra level 3 spell, and I can also now call lightning, as well as conjure animals.
Ooh.
everything else stays the same. I think that was it.
Yep, that's level 6 is a pretty big level for druids. For me, it's level 7. Alright, so, we've got... Wrath, where do you want to start? Do you want to start off with my kind of little backtrack, or do you want to...
We'll start with your small little backtrack.
Okay, well, what
basically, I... Basically, on the day that Edo or Dolos went out, gaining a certain item in a certain way, like... Mm-hmm. The day when he came back...
Mm-hmm.
That's the day when you left and did whatever you are going to do right now.
Okay, so there are a couple things. I would have told at least Auntie about what we saw from the scrying, which was a giant magic and fist, and we seem to be dealing with basically, they've been riled up by their god is basically what we seem to have happened. So I've been adventuring for less than 6 months and we've already run into a dragon and dealing with things that are empowered by their deity. So that's awesome. The other thing I wanted to do, since you mentioned, I should probably ask my sister first in case she has any idea. I want to know if she can do anything about that little scale that's still black. If she knows anything about it.
Basically, you go to your sister. What do you tell her?
I basically explain. I explain kind of like the fight, what happened. We think it's the power of their god, yada yada. And I got shot, and one of my scales now seems to be permanently black. And I was wondering if you could help me, like, figure out what's up with it, because I would rather leave Auntie for a last resort.
she kind of puts her hands up and is like, I haven't dealt with that sort of magic.
You don't even know, like, identify?
No. I'm more of a blow things up person.
Fair enough.
Blow the thing off.
Have we already established whether or not my auntie can enchant?
You haven't established that. She would technically be able to.
Okay.
Because technically all magic casters are able to enchant something.
Okay.
You are not a real magic caster, although you know some magic.
I know a
magic
spell. I know a spell.
Yeah,
that's
but
it.
You're not a real magic
caster. I can enchant. I can at most probably enchant a wall, a wand of a cantrip, which makes no sense because it's a cantrip, but whatever.
Tobinius could technically make such stuff. Yuma could as well.
Well, she's not here anymore, so.
And me?
She could. You can't.
Yeah,
your main class is not a spellcasting one.
Oh, I have to be main.
Alright, so I'm gonna ask her if she can enchant my shield. So, there are two things that I want. I want if they're possible. First one is I want to increase my AC flat. And the other one is see if I can maybe do something where I can get advantage where I try to shove with my shield. Those are two things I want. I want to know if it's possible, what my options are.
She said, I can do it. Either or. I'm not that good at enchanting. So I can do either one or the other, not both.
Okay, how strong is, how, don't tell me out loud. How strong of a, like, how, for the increase in armor class, how strong would it be? Or could you do it?
I could do the basics, really.
Okay.
Which, out of game, just means a plus one. It okay. would take a reasonable amount of time. And I'd prefer to do it with a fully new shield, so I actually go out to the blacksmith, and while he is making the shield, I'm going to enchant it.
Okay.
After the initial building, I'll have to enchant it for a decent amount of time longer.
Okay, can you give me a time range?
It really depends. It'll take at the very least 2 weeks.
It okay.
could take up to 6, depending on how well it goes.
Okay, and if you do the basic enchantment, if I wanted to get someone else to do a further one after that, would it be an entirely new magic, or could it possibly be enhanced?
You could enhance the defense potential, but the caster who will do it will have to know exactly what the initial person did, who enchanted it, or else you could use the wrong words or the wrong meaning and either contradict or make the spell like extremely weird.
Okay. Would you be willing to, like, write that out?
She looks at you. You have no idea how much work that is, do you?
Nope.
Yeah, I'm not going to just write it out.
Okay.
I've got better things to do than write it out.
How much would it cost me?
Well, first off, it'll cost you your basic shield.
So, 2 gold?
Where does it say the
price? I think it's 20 gold and weighs 2. Is what I think, but I'm not 100% sure.
I'm going back up to shields. It's close up here. I think it's
10 gold.
Costs 10, yeah. So that's the base price for the shield. Then the enchantments, it is mostly the time you pay for.
Family discount.
Yeah, she's like,
keeps me alive, I'm just saying.
Yeah, well, it takes a lot out of me as well.
I'm not saying you give it to me for free, I'm just, you know.
She, like, starts calculating a little bit. Normal rate would be this much, blah, 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 blah. Well, usually people would ask around 800 for this.
Wow! Holy crap! Okay. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, it is. Judging by the current magical weirdness.
Yeah.
The price is even slightly higher.
Wow.
I will do it for you for 700.
Including the shield?
That includes the shield.
For only plus one. Ugh, we better be getting a lot of gold later. Okay, I'll do it. So I'll hand her 70 platinum.
She looks at you. Huh, adventuring does you good, doesn't it?
A little bit. That's a big chunk of my resources, unfortunately.
Dragons and our gold.
Platinum in this case, but sure. So that's 70 platinum pieces, which means I would have that much left. Yes. Ouch. That hurts.
She says, I'm going to start work on this as soon as possible.
That would be nice.
It's like she will go out that same day to go to blacksmith, who will start making the shield, and she's present at that moment, which is also part of the cost.
Mm-hmm.
Her annoying a blacksmith.
Yeah.
So while he is basically melting the iron, molding it, making everything for the shield itself, she is continuously present, present, mumbling her spells to make it stronger, more durable. And after the smithing itself is done, she will have to continue to imbue the shield with magic to make it sustain itself, basically.
Okay. All right, so that's taken care of. Excuse me, that's taken care of. you want to whisper me what I whispered, the response to what I whispered you?
Yeah. I'll do it in
Steam
chat.
Okay.
Yeah, in the Steam chat.
The other thing...
Is that all you want to do?
No, there are two other things I want to do. I wanted to check out the comb building, or chome, or however it's pronounced, that we never checked out before.
Uh-huh.
So what's up with that? Okay.
You enter the building. It is a, rather small, kind of, it looks like semi-shady. The inside is basic, real basic. And for all intents and purposes, it's what we would call a bank. Something that hasn't shown up in this world as of yet.
Okay.
Here is where you can loan, or take loans, give loans, exchange currency, exchange... you can almost sell everything here. It's like a combination of a bank and a marketplace.
A bank and a pawn shop, I think, would be a better...
Not really a pawn shop idea, though. Because pawn shop is like, I've got this bullshit. Like, it's really cheap, really bad, here it is.
Not necessarily,
In a while, there's like a gem between them. These guys... They wouldn't take socks or anything. It's like, we want really interesting price.
A high-quality pawn shop.
Yeah, high-quality. But it's not necessarily a pawn shop. They will also deal with, like, large shipments of wood, stone, metal, food, that sort of thing.
Okay. So that's what that's about.
Yeah, in this case, it's still fairly small, as if the shop is just starting up.
Okay. And
it is, for anyone wondering, it is heavily guarded.
Yeah, no, I would have assumed. The only other thing I would be doing, and I could probably get my sister to help me a little bit, is I want to look for information throughout my auntie's vast library about to try to find those two those enemies that we fought, which I metagame know they're whites and cloakers, but I want to like find them, like I would find information about them, and then I also want to find information about lycanthropes, specifically the werewolves, and maybe a method of identifying them when they're not transformed, if possible. Otherwise, I'm going to practice sending mental images to Rita.
She'll love that. I want you to roll an investigation check for the entire duration of those weeks while you search for books, look at the information, try to process it, etc.
A single one or a bunch of them?
A single one.
Okay. I have my luck?
Nope.
Darn it. So investigation is just an intelligence, so it's a plus two.
I'm proficient in it.
Yeah, but you can't help.
Why not? Okay.
He's busy with all the stuff.
No, he's not.
Like,
he's not. He's not busy all the time.
Tobinius.
What's that?
While you are, speaking with nature, etc., you go around the city. Or do you actually go a decent amount away from Amida?
It's my impression. I went far away and communed with nature. And that's when I got a chance to practice out some of my new skills.
Okay. But it's not like you're going very far away from Amida.
Okay.
No, that was a question, not a statement.
Oh, yeah. No, I thought I was going to get, you know, commune with nature and kind of get away from all of the people types.
Okay, which takes you a decent amount away from it. Are you speaking to any animals in particular, or are you just walking around looking for a cave bear, which you inevitably find?
I guess I do talk to the animals as I come along, trying to find out where the cave bear is.
Okay, so while you are on your quote-unquote travels within the forest, you come across a single person. Lightly armored, just basic leather armor, basic sword, and he's making its way up north. It is a drow. His weapon is bloodied. He has like a small scar on his cheek. And finally he has a perception check. So on the no, it's actually
wow, that's three sixes in a row. What the heck? We're cursed!
So, on the back of his cloak, you can see this image.
Oh.
But it is not fully this image. In this case, the six doesn't show up. And the skull doesn't have its wings.
Okay.
He makes his way very quietly through the forest, and you are kind of intrigued to follow him.
Yeah, I guess for obvious reasons.
Yeah, for obvious reasons. And at a certain point, he doesn't seem to notice you, and at a certain point, he stops. He's standing on like a hill which ends in a small cliff. Couple of meters high, and he kind of sits low to the ground, looking over the edge of the cliff. You are standing behind him below the hill itself, and you can slowly but surely see him grab a dagger from his belt and he grabs the dagger first at the hilt, then he grabs it with his other hand on the blade itself, and he positions himself to throw the dagger.
In which direction?
Front, downwards.
So over the cliff?
Over the cliff down.
Can I tell how high the cliff is?
You don't really know because you're standing behind him. Like a couple of, like 30, 40 feet away, 60 feet away from him. In the forest.
Does it look like he's throwing it away or that he's going to try to hit somebody with it or something with it?
This is more of a look of hitting something or someone. It's like he's really just positioning the dagger within his hands to be able to throw. He's kind of motioning his hand back, standing ready to throw, but keeping very quiet at the same time.
Okay. I guess I'm going to do something.
Okay.
I'm going to call down lightning.
Okay.
Okay.
So, I have to concentrate up. Let's see. Have to concentrate. That's right. It's automatic. So, I haven't used it yet, so one sec.
Wrath, how's the weather?
The weather at this moment is relatively clear.
Oh, bummer.
It's a clear.
Not anymore.
Okay, so you got to make a saving throw, a dexterity saving throw, or else take 3d10 in lightning damage.
Is he technically surprised?
He most certainly is.
Okay, I can't remember if surprise means that they get no saves.
I don't think so. I've never read anything about it.
I'll check, but let's assume that they still do.
Yeah, go ahead. Describe what happens when you cast a spell. Tobinius.
Oh, sorry, I hadn't turned it on. Clouds start to form in the area above him. Let's see. I guess there's a 60-foot radius storm cloud kind of appears, and then lightning strikes down and hits him right on the head.
And what do you do to conjure up this? It's like, do you use your staff or?
No, just my hands, my fingers. Pulling the lightning down and pointing it at him.
So, what you first do is you gather a little bit of energy, magical essence in your hand. You have been practicing to do this for like the week prior. And you put your hand up in the air very slowly and release the magical energy. And you can see clouds, which weren't there to begin with, form and darken. And then one bolt of lightning crashes down as you motion your hand to where it should land. The drow, while focusing on his target with the dagger in his hand, can see the shadow from the cloud in the sky, and his basic instinct tells him to duck away. If whatever it is, it's big, it wants to do probably kill him or whatever, so he's going to duck away, which he manages. So the lightning bolt just smashes in right next to him. Does he take full or
half.
No damage?
Half damage if he saved.
Okay. So, the lightning bolt strikes him.
Or next to him, because it's an area of effect attack.
It strikes next to him as he jumps away. And you can see that part of his arm is burnt because of the intense heat of the bolt. And he turns, sees you, and immediately links the lightning bolt with you. And as you look at each other, it is clear that a fight is going to start, or has already started.
Roll initiative.
Roll initiative.
Let's see this, 1v1, because we have no idea. If you die, you're screwed. I'll just get out of the way. Ooh, nice!
Well, it's not bad. And I need... Where is it? I should save this one myself somewhere. There it is.
It's only a standard draw.
Oh, cheater.
How do I cheat? I roll it right.
I will say though, Wrath, technically, if he does have a full turn of surprise, he does still have a bonus action and a movement before the round starts.
Yeah. So you lock eyes and you can still do something before.
Well, I guess another bolt of lightning.
No, you can't do another action.
That's a bonus action movement, and then it's his turn, your turn, etc.
Okay, so he's 60 feet away?
Give or take, yeah. 60 feet.
Okay, so he can't get me in this, unless he has some sort of power. Okay,
he could dash and reach you, but, you know, whatever.
Yeah, he could, but he can't.
Attack, you're right.
Yeah. So, I'm just gonna prepare.
Okay. So you are kind of standing a little bit wide to, either move to his side when he comes to attack. And you can see him look at his dagger, look at you, and he starts throwing the dagger.
He throws the dagger at me, is that what you said?
Yeah, he throws the dagger at you.
Okay.
Which is to be expected. And... He sits ready, throws the dagger, but you can see that the burn marks on his arm is bothering him, and the dagger just goes wide. It doesn't even come close to you. He then kind of looks surprised and puts his hand on his weapon and starts to draw it. Your turn.
Okay. Crack.
So another bolt of lightning comes down from the sky.
You're rolling like Yuma, what's going on, Toby?
But this man is like, he grabbed his weapon, and as he pulls it out, your bolt of lightning strikes, and it just strikes the weapon, going through his arm all the way down to his feet, and then releases into the ground. The drow is now burnt to a crisp.
He's dead?
He's dead. His weapon falls to the ground, heavily damaged, as is basically his entire armor and him.
Okay, well, I want to run up to the cliff and see what he was going to throw the knife at.
You run up to the cliff, and... right now, you have just unleashed two lightning bolts from the sky, which are deafening. And as you run to the cliff, you can see two drow, one female, one male, looking up to the cliff. They are unarmed, nor do they have any clothes on, for that matter. And they see you standing there on top of the cliff, and they just... turn around and start running into the forest, naked as they are.
You know, I still have the lightning, right?
Yeah.
No, I'm just kidding. No. He was going to throw the knife at them, so maybe I'll just let them go. I'll look for the knife.
What do you say?
I'll look for the knife, though, that he threw at me.
Okay, make a perception check to see if you can look where the knife is and then find it.
Yeah.
So, you start looking around, and it takes a lot longer than you expected, but you eventually find the knife, and you think to yourself that this is, like, the worst throw you've ever seen.
Did you roll a natural one? Just out of curiosity.
No.
Oh, okay.
He rolled a two.
Mm. Anything special about the knife, or is it just a normal throwing dagger?
It's just a basic dagger.
Okay, I toss it aside. And I search the drow. Anything on him?
You grab, like, a small pouch, which has one gold coin and a few copper pieces. Like, four copper pieces.
Okay.
What about his other weapon? What is it?
His other weapon is a by now extremely damaged short sword.
Fair enough.
It has been on some parts it has been cracked, on other parts it had just been melted by the thunder.
Lightning.
Or lightning that you threw down.
Cool. Well, then I continue on my way then.
Okay. And that was like the most interesting thing that happened to you while you were out communing with nature and kind of testing your skills.
Did he find his cave bear?
He did. We already established that.
Okay.
So I had a really good time then.
Found a cave bear, killed the drow.
Yeah.
It's all good.
It was a very good time for Tyraneus. I've already had Dolos. Are you going to do anything else? Or already
He ran around and...
Yeah, around, stole shit.
Big surprise.
Sold some stuff.
Killed some people, you know.
So we now return where we last left off.
Yep.
And that was the moment that Gumby stood in front of a crowd inside of a reasonably sized church, speaking about the great goddess. Go ahead.
Oh, I thought you were gonna continue because I have no idea. that's
we established the goddess together.
Yeah. She's the goddess of light. She is.
You're wrapping
the
up.
Greatest goddess of all goddesses, and yeah.
Generally amazing.
Yeah, Melisandre is. Let me see if I wrote it down anywhere. Well, I mean, she's basically.
Her light will cleanse all darkness.
Right, and all elements of darkness, which includes like deceit and fear, I guess.
Yes.
You gave this speech. Maybe make a performance roll. I don't know.
Make a charisma check.
Oh, not a performance? I'm proficient in performance.
No, you're not proficient.
It's a performance, then go ahead.
He's not, it doesn't matter.
Actually, it's charisma. Oh, never mind. Yeah, I'm not.
Okay, charisma roll.
You're not amazing anymore. Another six!
Clearly not.
So, the crowd is not really warming up to you. The fact that you are in her church is the only thing that makes people actually pay some sort of attention to you. You have done a better job. Definitely done a better job.
I didn't study enough this last week.
Dad, or you didn't ask Melisandre for guidance. It just didn't really go well.
This is going to be interesting.
So, you step up, step off of the podium platform, and another person stands up, and he's like slowly clapping. Thank you for your words, who will guide us all. And then he talks a little bit further about Melisandre. This man's words are generally more effective than your words were. He knows the city well. You don't really, and he knows what the people of the city really need or want to hear, and he just strikes the right chords.
I'm still kind of new.
Yeah, so he really helps smooth, like, what you said, and he changes it a little bit to make it more important for the people of Amida. And he stops his speech by telling that Melisandre will protect us in these dying, dire times. He will protect all of us, our fathers, our sons, our husbands who are out fighting. And everybody like praises Melisandre, ending it all. People start standing up and getting out of the church, chapel.
With one exception.
Go ahead.
One three? Or three?
One. I'm alone.
No one else probably. Went. Dolos didn't went searching, he went stealing.
Well, Tyraneus I'm the, regardless, still... regardless, I'm the only one you would see if it was me or Dolos.
That's all.
Should I steal?
Dolos would probably be somewhere in the back stealing stuff.
Yeah. Another six.
Oh, damn.
So I walk up. I can't remember. We got his name before, right?
No. He was introduced as a friend of Yuma's father. Nothing more, nothing less.
Okay. So I walk up and I say, excuse me, you wouldn't happen to know a magic user with the last name Bognym, would you?
Actually, I do. I've been with his party.
Ah, I see. Well, we met up with him and I'm going to hand him the letter while I'm saying this. And apparently you're looking for people to adventure with, and we have a spot open, I guess you could say.
Cool. How did you get this spot?
Wait, do you read the letter?
Well, yeah, I check it, and then what do you want me to roll to see if I recognize the signature? I've been with them.
You open the letter. You open a letter and you immediately know that this is like your friend, but just by the way he writes. Okay. It is a fairly lengthy letter telling you that he is okay, that he's fine, and it ends with I have found a few people who might need your guidance and the guidance of the light. Would you please help them in their struggles?
And my eyes get wide and I say, I can start today.
Well, I believe we've been exploring quite a bit and we're kind of in a relaxing period right now, but for the next couple days, you know, I think we get to know each other and each other's abilities would probably be for the best. So I'm still waiting for my other companions to finish about their business.
There is a PS on their letter.
Okay, that would have been good to know.
In very fine print, completely on the bottom, which most people would miss, but you know where to look. It says,
PS usually comes after the letter.
Yeah, but it's like kind of hidden on a place.
I know where this is going, this is amazing.
So, on that bottom part, it says, PS, one of the members has a slight problem with... he basically says, one of the members has loose hands. Keep an eye on him, would you?
And you know
that
means
I'm not
stealing.
Proficient in perception. Yep. I know what that means.
Drake, why do you keep doing it?
But you don't.
Do you mention this at all?
No.
No, you didn't. Okay, because you want to know, like, maybe who might. Okay, whatever. Because you don't know. It could be me.
Yeah.
Could be anyone.
Was the letter sealed when it was given to me?
The letter was originally still sealed, yes.
Okay.
Alright.
Then I'll change my answer. I'll say, sure. Sounds fun.
Okay, good. Right now we're at my auntie's place, and there's enough room for you to squeeze in between some books. To basically crash out until we decide to go further. We're not exactly sure what we're going to do yet. I'm waiting for everyone to reconvene and we'll decide from there.
What's your auntie's name?
Good question. Give me a second. I named a lot of people in my defense.
And remembered little.
Yeah, well, I did this almost a year ago. Give me a break.
The sad part is we actually did. It's like 9 months or something.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Lashana.
Okay.
Lashana.
I think I've heard of her. I've been here for a little bit, a little while.
Yeah.
That name kind of rings a bell.
She's got a reputation.
I might have seen or heard of her.
I don't know if it's necessarily a good one, but she's got a reputation.
Can I roll to see how well I remember?
She got... Yeah, you can roll.
Intelligence or insight?
It'd be intelligence.
Or knowledge?
It would be straight up intelligence.
No, it's not intelligence. This is more getting from people.
History?
So it's more like a charisma thing. It's like
history?
What you get.
Well, then wouldn't
no,
it be...
This
wait,
is how
wouldn't
much
it be,
I myself remember.
No, this is how much... Remembering is intelligence. If you want to do like how much he's heard, that would be perception.
Yeah, then it's
he hasn't
perception.
Asked around.
It's like how much you have heard from people
okay.
saying and...
Yeah, so it kind of rings a bell.
Yeah, you heard a little bit of her name mentioned... And that she basically has about the same number, if not more, books than a local library. With a little side note that she is considered to be a reasonably powerful magic user. Mm-hmm. Not all powerful, but she can hold her own.
Okay, I know my merry around magic, so...
You would think so, yes. I take it that all of you just, or at least the two of you, make it up. Dolos, what are you rolling?
Nothing.
Because you failed, didn't you?
No.
Dude, can I use my perception roll to see if I can hear this guy?
You don't have to because he's not
guy.
There. He is not there. He was busy, probably sleeping at this moment, so he could go out stealing in the evening night.
He's not in the church stealing stuff.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, I thought we were at the auntie thing.
No, they just make their way up to the auntie right now.
Oh, okay.
Which is where you are. When at the house of the Andi, what would you do?
Look around, get to know people. Ask questions about the story, like how they got to where they are. What kind of adventures they've had.
So, just general conversation. It is now 13 days past the resting period. Tyraneus, you return at this moment.
Days? Okay. Yeah. Well, one of the questions I would ask is how do you know Erevan Bognym?
Oh, you're asking me?
Well, no, just general question.
Well, as it turns out, we actually the party position you're filling previously belonged to his daughter.
He found his daughter?
Yeah, pretty much. They kind of found each other. So she went with him, a little worse for wear, and that's why we have basically more than enough room for another person, and I'm very happy that we'll have the abilities of a cleric, given what we've encountered, so.
What have you encountered?
Demons.
Oh. Sounds fun. No sarcasm. It sounds fun.
As you mentioned demons... Just the word itself. What does it do to you, Gumby?
His eyes light up.
that's what I said. It sounds fun.
Yeah.
Like you're like not necessarily in a gleeful sound away, but it's not sarcasm either. Because part of my mission is to dispel darkness.
You're actually looking forward to it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Your expression looks the exact same as Dolas when he's about to go steal something.
Probably.
except this is... What, yeah, okay.
It's like you experience the same sort of joy. Which in some cases could be considered problematic in itself.
Mm.
Finding joy in killing creatures even though the creatures themselves are evil. Kind of evil. A little bit. But your training has just been so thorough that anything evil must die.
Well, I'm also lawful good, too.
So
I don't know how well that fits this, but...
You'll do it within the law.
With the conscience, yeah.
No, not necessarily with the conscience. The law you follow is the law of Melisandre, and if her law states this creature is evil, it is evil, you'll kill it, and you will never feel bad about it.
Okay.
That's like the strictness that you have.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
When you try to contact your auntie about if she has time...
Well, I don't try to contact her, I just wait until she comes back.
Yeah, she does... she is... The entire time, she's basically downstairs.
Yeah, that's fine.
Training with your sister and working on your item.
Mm-hmm.
Your sister herself is kind of complaining about it, that thanks to you, she doesn't get the attention she wishes she could get.
Okay, I console her and say, it cost me 70 platinum, so...
He's like, so? It cost me my research! And you can kind of see the work of your auntie beginning to seep through to her. Like, she is very invested in what she's doing in her research. She is as headstrong as your mother and father are. Which is...
Pretty headstrong.
Pretty headstrong, no surprises whatsoever. She's also about as headstrong as you yourself are, so...
Yeah, well...
On the 14th day... at this moment, Tobinius is already back for a day. Everybody has seen each other, at least spoken a little bit with each other. Your auntie just pops up very quickly, and she says, I'm sorry, it's going to take another week.
Mm, awesome.
She says it slightly irritated. As if she is, yeah. What can you say? She might be unhappy because it's taking longer. She wants to do other things. Whatever it may be.
Hey, I paid 70 platinum. What do you want from me? okay. Well, then I'm up for staying another week. I'd still like to look, try to find, go through some more books, maybe find some more information. I'm okay with that.
The information you found as of now, you won't find any more, by the way.
At least not here. I can go to like a local library or something, right?
Which one do you want to hear about first?
We'll start with the werewolves, just if there's any way to identify them when they're not transformed.
Okay, what it states about lycanthropy, werewolves, is that they are extremely difficult to find out when they are in their normal human form. Most werewolves, while in their normal human form, look a little bit... They look... tattered, mostly. They look like they have been in fights a lot. They generally don't take that well, good care of their own clothing, etc. It's more that it doesn't interest them as much anymore. They tend to be more aggressive. Just generally more like an aggressive wolf type of person. They also usually move out of cities and villages, etc., to go more into the wild, where they feel more accepted and more, less haunted as well.
So they're like an evil druid?
A little bit. It is more like they are afraid that they will, that other people will find out that they are what they are. And that's the reason why most of them will inevitably flee into the wilderness unless they can find some sort of comfort, or they are well at hiding it or something like that.
Okay. What about the whites?
Whites? Let's go down. A white is, as you know by now, it's... Mm-hmm. Yeah?
I'll say, because I don't technically know what it's called. I had to look for it.
Yeah. You basically search for the undead, and after a while you find a picture in one of the books with a small description. The picture is similarly enough to say that it is.
Also, the whole life draining thing is kind of a dead giveaway.
It says that like a very small part they drain life, but that's about it.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't say how strong it is. What it does say is the word white means person. In days past, they are neither dead or alive. They drain people's energy. That's the life stealing part. And they, like most undead, dislike the sun.
Okay.
Very little extra about anything has really been written in this book.
And then finally,
or the books that you find.
And then finally, looking for stuff on the cloakers.
Your auntie has very few books that even describe the creatures of the Underdark.
Okay.
You find one which fairly quickly glosses over them. It's what it says about the cloaker there is it thanks its name because it resembles a cloak. It hangs in caves, passages in the dark, preferably waiting for its prey, and when it finds its prey, it'll suffocate it or bite and poke it to death. It says that they are very dangerous creatures.
Mm-hmm.
That's about it what you find in this book about them. It's like a very small book with a couple of Underdark creatures written in there with a slight description.
Okay. Well, is everyone else okay with chilling out for a week?
I guess I could steal more stuff for a week.
Do you say that out loud?
Commune?
Yes.
So, it's pretty...
I'm not gonna lie about it.
Gummy, you hear this person say, I'll probably steal some more stuff.
And you see me roll my eyes.
And you see me, poof, disappear.
And what's your reaction on that?
My eyes get big, and not in a good way.
Sure.
And what do you think?
I consider doing car lighting.
But you're in a house. That's inconvenient
for a
exactly.
lot of people.
And I'm already.
I'm just
gone.
Getting to know these guys.
Okay.
Okay. So I'm just doing the working out, helping Rita learn how to read, and trying to send the mental images. Also, I guess trying to establish my feelings for Rita now that we kind of think we're like. I have an undefined relationship now, because it's really awkward, but whatever.
Together
just
while
like
reading,
relationships in real life.
Together while reading, etc. The both of you come to the conclusion that you are, that you love each other, but you're not in love with each other.
Okay.
Missing the other person would be like missing a very close family member, which she basically is to you now. She is as important to you as your mother, your brother, your sister, your father, your auntie.
Fair enough. I mean, it was kind of always like that, but whatever.
It's more like you used to like travel together, and while it slowly grew, you slowly grew closer to each other. It's now... very sad that even if both of you would do something extremely horrendous, you'd probably still forgive them.
Wow, so it's even closer than family, technically.
Yeah, it's a very, very close relationship.
Okay.
But it's not one based in love.
It's not romantic,
it's
yeah.
Romantic, yeah.
Okay. No, I totally get it.
Her reading is going... fairly well, really, since she has almost direct contact with access to your memories and to your parts of your knowledge. she's fairly easy able to pick it up. The image sending is still wonky at best. It is very unreliable.
Okay, but is it noticeably improved at all?
It improves. Not swiftly, but it does improve, and she has started to do the same to you. Neither of you are really good at it, but it's improving slowly.
It could definitely come in handy in the future.
Yep. While you are in the city, news hits you.
Okay.
It is as bad news usually does. It spreads like wildfire, and within a couple of within a day, everybody has heard this news and is speaking about it in hushed and fearful tones. I think it would be Gumby, you're the first to hear it, probably, since you are the one who would go out to the church and speak.
Mm-hmm.
One of the dwarven cities has fallen. It has fallen to the continuous attacks of orcs and goblins and other filth. The city that has fallen is Burborim, which is completely on the left side of the Iron Tip mountain range.
Okay.
People speak about, well, utter death and destruction, basically. The dwarves themselves are hit very hard, and the few dwarves that you hear speak about it, they speak about it with a combination of loss and anger, frustration.
Any fear?
Yes, there is fear for the survival of their kin.
Do we hear any news about the Domor doing anything about it?
There is no news about the Domor doing anything about it. There are some rumors that the higher-ups in the Vindar Alliance themselves are contemplating on moving into the moving their armies into the mountains. But of course there are risks involved with that as well.
Mm-hmm.
Not only losing your army to
the weather.
Not only the combat with the orcs, which could be detrimental, also the ever-present risk of the Domor to the north, and the slightly lessened risk, but still a risk of attacks from the west.
The west?
West, which would then come from the Fila kingdom.
Mm.
And while there is a truce, so to say, the relations aren't necessarily warm. So there is still some distrust.
Okay. And that's the kind of the week gone by?
That is kind of what happens as the week goes by. And the rumors at what happened, there's more and more news pouring in from what happened from a merchant who came from the Iron Tip Mountains, the few that still dare to, and the even fewer that still make it through. And basically any merchant that makes it through doesn't go back inside the mountains. It has become too dangerous. And the news that spreads very quickly is the people speak of creatures coming out of the mountains, joining the orcs and goblins, all sorts of different creatures. One more fearsome than the other.
Awesome. Had a different meaning.
Yeah, there are words that the drow have started to join some orc bands in raidings and pillagings and basic war fighting. The next of kin from goblins, the bugbears, have started joining them. And more of them are flooding to the Iron Tips. You hear also from within the Tinder Alliance news that the forest goblins are starting to move up north in ever-pressing numbers, as if all of them are gathering in the Iron Tips.
Okay.
Feeling the whims of war from their other kin. Parties have been asked to basically destroy any goblin or orc force they see, if they are capable. And bounties have been started up for these creatures to make it more enticing for people to
within the Vindar Alliance?
Within the Vindar Alliance itself. For any goblin you kill within the Vindar Alliance will net you 2 gold pieces. And any creature, a goblin chief will net you 20 gold pieces. An orc, your basic fighting orc, would net you between 10 and 15 gold pieces, depending. Okay. And if you find like an orc war chief, that would easily get you 100 gold pieces. And that is proof of kill.
Is there an example of proof of kill besides the ear, or is it just the ear or something?
Ears will work. They prefer to just drag. The best case scenario, you bring them a body.
We'll bring them a head.
If you bring them heads, they will also happily accept.
Yeah. No. I see opportunity. So hearing all this information, I'm just waiting for my shield, and then I want to identify what I've got, and then we'll go.